mensajes desde la calle.
Today we've been joined by Trinidad and Tobago European-based player Keston Julien, not too long ago wearing national colours in the World Cup qualifiers for the 2022 campaign. Keston obviously has been enjoying a very successful season with his club in Moldova, their club FC Sheriff Tiraspol being the first club in Moldova to qualify for the group stage of the UEFA Champions League. But before we get into conversation, we want to extend our well wishes and prayers to one of our own, Kevin Molino, who today received the news that he's going to be out for 12 months, at least up to 12 months, because of another ACL reconstruction surgery that is required by him following an injury in training yesterday at Columbus School. So Kevin, well wishes to you, and our thoughts are with you. Obviously, we know you've been through this before, and we want to wish you a safe and speedy recovery. Keston, obviously, for someone like you, you know, this is what you guys do. You depend on your body for earning a living and to be able to carry out your profession as a professional footballer. How does someone deal with something like this, you know?
I think, you know, with these injuries, you know, it's very difficult, you know. Knees are something, it's play a big part in your body, especially when you're playing football. And, you know, I think this is his third time getting his injury, which I think will be mentally hard on him, but I think he's a strong person. He had this before, but yeah, he just had to stay mentally good, and I think he will recover well and yeah, come out again and do what he do best.
Of course. And obviously for you now, you know, you're looking ahead to a new chapter in your career. I mean, UEFA Champions League football is the pinnacle of football in Europe and one of the biggest leagues, highest competitions in world club football. You know, how do you feel about this, and what's it been like for you back in Moldova over the last 24 to 48 hours?
Yeah, it was really a crazy feeling. Our goal was to qualify for the Champions League group. People think we couldn't do it, but you know, we get some new players and they motivated us, and you know, coach always said that he would take us to the Champions League, and people said yeah, we won't make it, and you know, we just stick to our plan, what the coach tell us, and you know, and yeah, we play in Champions League group stage now, and yeah, it's a wonderful feeling. Everyone, I think every footballer dream of playing in the Champions League some point of their life, and you know, I just 22 years old, and yeah, it's happened at a young age in my life that I'm really thankful for, and I hope I could play in the group stage and show what I can do.
Obviously, you're following in some big footsteps. Just our most recent player would have been Kaleem Highland back in 2011, 2012. Then you have the likes of Russell Latapy, you know, Dwight York, Marvin Andrews, and the list goes on in terms of players from Trinidad and Tobago and the Caribbean who've been able to grace the Champions League stage. But for you, in a nutshell, tell us about your journey. You know, coming through the ranks in Trinidad and Tobago, Gasparilla has been your hometown. I mean, from college football into national youth football, national team, and obviously entering the stage in Europe.
Well, to be honest, well, I come from Gasparilla, from a small team called Gasparilla Youth, where I started to play well amateur football, and then well, I went to Derby Connection youth team, and actually I was a fat fella. And well, for 1 year I decided to stop playing football because I think, you know, making stands are fat. And then a year after, I dropped plenty weight, and I decided to take football serious. And well, that was on a 50 with Derby Connection. And yeah, everything just went uphill from there. Coach Byron was playing a big part in my career. He believed in me a lot, you know. And from under 15, go straight up to the senior team with Derby Connection. They show me a lot of respect as a player. They give me a lot of chances. And yeah, after that, you know, played in national under 17 in Honduras, where I scored a good solo goal. And from there, it's like my life actually changed. A couple agents contact me, and well, this one agent come with a good deal and say you want to take me to Holland. And after that was, yeah, the rest was history.
Excellent, and history so far now making you the youngest player, the newest player from Trinidad and Tobago to be able to have an opportunity to play UEFA Champions League football. At the club at Tiraspol there in Moldova, give us an idea what's it like in terms of the atmosphere, the setup and the league itself.
Oh well, yeah, it's not a big country, you know. Our league is not big. Well, our club is the biggest club in Moldova, most championships, most Moldovan cups. The league is just 10 teams. It's not a very difficult league, but it's very competitive because when everyone comes to play us, they come to win, you know. They want to show the best against the best team in the league. So it's also challenging, but for me, I've been capable to cope with it. I also have in my position also as a good left back, and he's from Brazil. But yeah, it also challenged me to become a better player and fight for my spot on the team. But overall, everything has been going really, really, really good in Moldova so far.
And obviously now with this qualification, this is going to be a big step for the league and for the club. It's going to bring a lot more interest to the league itself. And now you all are going to inspire clubs from Moldova to aspire to something like this because now they're seeing possibilities.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course, you know, more the club is gonna get recognized more. I think yesterday the club ranked from 108 to the go to number 70 above a lot of clubs, you know. So this qualifying for this group stage had really open up a lot of doors for the club and for a lot of players, you know, so people can recognize us more because we are really, really, really top club, you know. I think we have 18 football fields. Yeah, 18 training pitches, we have an indoor field, well, really, really professional club.
Sounds like a place that Trinidad and Tobago could do with coming for overseas training camp at some point in time, right?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, it's really, really, really good.
What's the composition of the team like in terms of overseas players and players from Moldova, national team, etc.?
Well, actually, we have the most overseas players. We have 17 different countries in the club itself. So we have 17 different countries, which it makes it difficult because Champions League, when you allow 16 players from outside Moldova to be on the team. And so that make it even more competitive because players want to play Champions League. So, but we don't really have much.
Tell us some of the countries that you know you all have except for.
We have Greece, Brazil, Ivory Coast, Mali, a lot of African players.
Right.
Well, me being the only Caribbean and Trinidad player. Yeah, that's about it. But a lot of Brazilian guys, also guys from France. Yeah.
And I'm hoping, Keston, that you haven't had to really face up any sort of racism or discrimination in the league there.
No, I never experienced it here while playing. And although we didn't really play with much fans, even when we played fans, we never even get any racial remarks or anything like that.
Right. And now, what's the size of this city that your club is based in? Has it been jubilant for the last 24 hours or so because of the qualification? What's your reaction from the
Yeah, I think they want to have a holiday or something like that. Because our city is Moldova, is one country, right. And Tiraspol is considered itself like another country. So when you're coming into Moldova and you're coming into Tiraspol, you have to pass a border to come into Tiraspol.
So it's almost like Tobago coming to Trinidad kind of thing.
Yeah, it's like that. But yeah, it's not really a big city, but it's a lot of people live here also.
All right, perfect. All right, so for you now, obviously the rest of the year is going to be an exciting one heading into 2022. What are some of your ambitions? And I'm thinking as well that you have your eyes set on returning to the national team at some point in time.
Yeah, I mean, my goal is to really come back into the national team. We didn't qualify for the World Cup, but I think we planning to bounce back, you know, and yeah, do what we do best. My goal is really to play as much Champions League group stage game as possible, you know. Even if they come out of a group, but to be really, 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 really good. So, yeah, to play a lot of football in this last 4 or 5 months that we have in the year.
And before we go, just give us an idea as to what your regime is like as a professional footballer in Moldova with this club, especially now that you all are preparing for the Champions League. What's the daily program like for you?
Wake up, eat breakfast. I don't live too far from the club, 10 minutes. I mean, I don't have a license, so I also call a Uber. Call a Uber, go training. Basically now that we have one training a day, because we have one games Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday, and stuff like that. Training don't really be high intensity. Some days, only 2-3 days, so it'll be high intensity and stuff like that. And then just come home and I just here by myself. I don't have my family or anything. Yeah. Hoping to bring them in the end of the year, but you know, with COVID and stuff like that. But yeah, it's really an easy lifestyle for me here. I don't experience nothing bad.
So obviously, you're able to focus fully on football.
Yeah, fully focus on football is just being home training. Might just go to a restaurant and eat. I'm not really a person to go out here and party much. It's not really Trinidadian culture, you know.
Yeah.
So it's just home football, and I think that is good for me as well. You know, I could develop more as a player, and yeah, that's really good for me.
All right, perfect. Keston, we want to thank you for the time. Obviously, it's exciting times for you as a professional player. We want to wish you the best. Yes. Stay in touch with you. Great, thank you very much.
Okay, no problem.